And Randolph woke up the next morning. He put the young man out of his house. Put him out. And told him not to come there again. Leroy, talk to me.
Well, thanks for taking my call. I have a 19-year-old daughter, and so I kind of know what he... But, and I am divorced, but I would tell you, if I was him, I would make it clear that I don't want a divorce. Divorce is not an option for me. But ain't nobody sleeping in my house, you know. I'm going to tell you that right now. Ain't nobody sleeping here. If you bring the guy here, and, you know, he did the right thing by putting him out, I would tell the guy when he got there, look, man, you can't spend a night now. You can come over and you can do this. You know, I mean, I would just put it land like that. And I let him know, look, divorce is not an option. We ain't getting no divorce, but ain't no man but sleeping here. If he's going to take her out, fine. But there ain't nobody sleeping in my house. I'm just sorry that's not going to happen. But you got to tell the guy that. And once he tells the guy, I believe, and I could be wrong, I think that once he tells the guy that, when he comes knocking on the door, you know, then the girl would get the message. Because that was, you know, and then that sends a message. But it's a way to handle it. I believe it's a way to handle it because, you know, after 20 years of marriage and you raised 3 kids that's not yours and adopted them, I think that, because a lot of black men face the fact of being disrespected in their own home for whatever the reasons are. But the respectful way to handle it is tell everybody, look, you know, even the guys who bring the girls there, you're not having sex in my house. Just not going to do it. Now, if you want to do it, fine. You know, you can go outside. I'll even loan you the money for a hotel, but you're not going to do it here. You're not going to disrespect. And I think they'll get it.
Leroy, you would lend him money?
Yeah.
To take your daughter to a hotel?
Not to take my daughter to the hotel, but I mean, I'm just telling you, because you got to understand, it's not, I'm from the old school, okay, but you're not going to have sex in my house. If you need hotel, and I think any guy worth his salt, you know, worth the air that he breathes, wouldn't take the money. It was, would look at it as an embarrassment. And these young guys, the other part of it is, they don't have male figures like I had. See, when I grew up, being a man was, you could learn it on the street. Now you can't do that no more. You know, there's no more men, black men, to teach young black men how to be men. They just don't do it, you know. I mean, that's just the facts of the day. But you have to tell me, the reality is, look, man, you can come, you're welcome to come, but you can't spend a night. And he'll get that. I think they'll get it. Because no man wants to be embarrassed. You know, it's embarrassing. Now, these guys, they think that, hey, it's okay. I'll sleep with the mama, I'll sleep with the daughter and the sisters if they let me, you know. And you got people, because you got to look at it, Mildred, y'all make excuses for these people. You make excuses for the dope dealers and for the irresponsible.
You know what? Let me just say, I just love it when you call in here and I have to check you on generalizing and putting me into that madness.
Well, now, I know y'all
allow this. No. All right, Leroy, thanks for weighing in. Let's go downriver and check in with Mike. Hi, Mike.
Hey, how you doing, Mildred?
I'm good. So what do you think about this situation?
Well, Mildred, I can only say one thing. I'm from the old school. But I'm just amazed at the disrespect that this young lady is showing her father, her adopted father. It's amazing. I mean, this man did probably everything for this young lady, and she's going to put him under that type of stress and scrutiny. That's ridiculous. I mean, I really feel sorry for him, and I really still feel sorry for her. I mean...
Well, I'm concerned that the mother wants to, as they used to say it back in the day, uphold her in this madness. The mother is getting upset with her husband.
And that's the other ridiculous thing in this whole scenario, Bill. That's ridiculous. I mean, how can a man feel that he's a man and come to his house and he can't and he get disrespected like that? You know, I'd be beside myself. I can only give a man credit for being, you know, for being as calm as he's been. He's showing principles, but he's doing it in a calm, seem like respectable way. And he should be getting credit for that.
All right. Thank you so much, Mike. Appreciate hearing from you. Let's go to Southfield. Hi, Carolyn.
Oh, good morning. Good afternoon, Mildred. I totally agreed with the father. I have two young daughters, 25 and 22. Yes, they can have company. No, they cannot have no company upstairs in their bedroom. I think the father is totally in line. I can't believe the mother is saying, okay, so technically he is those children's father. He adopted them. So she's willing to throw that away for a daughter. We do a lot of kids. I mean, you know, we do a lot of things for our children. But when you're wrong, you're wrong. So the wife should be standing by her husband who adopted her children. I would have loved to hear that from my girl. My son is alive, and he's not in their life. So my new life.